All right, guys, almost half. 1,000 miles on the Pegasus 37s. I got like 0.4 miles left of running the shoe of 1,000 miles. I can't believe it, 1,000 miles in these shoes, and they're holding up. Definitely, if you have not ran the Pegasus series before, I would definitely highly recommend it. Welcome back. I just finished 15 miles on the treadmill, and today I completed 1,025 miles in the Pegasus 37s. Definitely a workhorse shoe. You can definitely tell the wear on the toes there. It still has the little bit of recoil to it. The cushioning still pretty good back here. I mean, it's still pretty solid. You can definitely tell a little difference there compared to when I first started running with the shoe. It has lost its balance a little bit from the shoe, but definitely overall, the tread has really held up over the time. You can definitely tell a little wear right there on the side of the shoe there. That's kind of where I'd push off a little bit more. I'd pronate a little bit there. This is my right shoe, and then the left shoe as well. Not so bad there. I definitely got a lot of wear out of this shoe. I can tell you that. And you should probably ask him, that's crazy. Why would you want to do 1,000 miles in a shoe? It was because it kept on holding up. And I was like, I can still run in these shoes. They feel great. And in fact, you can tell the left side, I don't pronate as much on the left side there. I compared, and I strike a little bit more on the outside here of my foot. But overall, I feel great with them. We're still running with these shoes. I ran 15 miles on the treadmill, and I probably can still run a few miles with these shoes. And I probably will still run a little bit in these shoes, and I'm probably definitely retire them, but may use them for shorter distances and speed work or, plyometric exercises. They're still pretty good shoes to kind of wear around and maybe clean them up a little bit. Kind of wanted to keep them dirty so that way everyone can see just the wear that you can have on these shoes after 1,025 miles shoes. So the outsole, you can tell that the material has still held up. Usually if I've ran about 400 miles or so with Hokas, they do tear right there, but this material is pretty strong. So I'm really pleased with the material that Nike has given. The only thing I found that I had issues with, you can maybe see a little bit of stain right there. Occasionally I would have a little rubbing on my little toe in that area there on the material. And that might be just because of my sock, definitely might need some different socks. So it may not just necessary because of that, might be just because of me, not wearing the proper socks there. But it doesn't happen all the time. It's just only an occasion that it has happened. This depends on much sheer force and up and down. Here in Arkansas, there's a lot of hills, so that might have been causing some irritation on the little toe. Again, if you're looking for a cheap workhorse shoe, you can still get these probably on eBay for probably under $100. You know, definitely I would go for it. They are a good shoe. It's a neutral shoe, so definitely, but it does have a good insole inside of them. I think definitely has some good stability, a little twisting in them, so you have a little bit more room. But definitely I think it's a good type of shoe if you want long miles in them and be able to train every day in these shoes. I think you can definitely do speed work in these shoes. I've done long run in them in these shoes. I've done 5Ks in these shoes. In fact, while back, maybe link the vlog on this, I did a kind of Hyperion Tempos versus the Pegasus 37s in a 5K race. And these, I did better in these compared to the Hyperion Tempos. And it was a different course, so it definitely wasn't true to test, but you know, definitely I think it was pretty accurate that these shoes have a little bit more balance, a little bit more cushion to them, and definitely can withstand longer runs. I've done long runs in Hyperion Tempos and definitely can tell a little bit more impact on those shoes because of less foam, a little harder foam compared to this shoe here, and definitely I think you'd be very pleased. So let's look at the stack height. Usually around men's 9s, it's 9.6 ounces. This is men's 11, so it's probably a little heavier, probably 10 ounces or so. And then the heel height is 28 millimeters, and then the forefoot height is 18 millimeters. So that's a stack height of a total of 10 millimeters for the heel drop there. So it's not too extreme with the heel drop. 10 millimeters or so. So definitely, I think you will definitely be pleased with these shoes, especially, like I said, I've worn these for 1,000 miles. So definitely I know what it does and how I feel with these shoes. I don't have any knee pain or hip pain from them, even after that too. And again, it's all depending on if you're running properly too, making sure you're not overstriding, crisscrossing, over dipping your heels down. So definitely, I think you'll be really pleased with these shoes. For a long duration, you know, getting in the trenches type of workout with these shoes, I think will be, your possibilities are very, very great with these shoes here. again, I probably am going to get some new shoes here. And then I'll do a vlog. I won't want everyone to have a surprise what type of shoes I'll have. And again, I'll probably retire these shoes for everyday use once I get those shoes here. So again, 1,025 miles, very unbelievable. I can't believe I've done that many miles. And I've had these since May, so it's from May to now, December now. Yeah, so May through December, I've really worked hard in these. So that's about 7 months worth of usage out of these shoes here. So that's quite easily, it's about 4 months or so out of shoes, 400 miles. And typically, you probably can stop at 400 miles on these shoes if you want to. But again, shoes are expensive, and I want to try to get my money's worth out of them. I feel like I did. I think I got these for about, decreased prices, and I had a little gift card, about $60 or so at Academy. And again, I don't think they have these at Academy anymore, so you might have to look on eBay or other places online. And again, I think I've seen you can get these under $100. Or so, and you can also get these used. So I think I saw some used prices that look, shoes would look better than this right here. See, these probably would be like $5 or so, maybe $2 for these shoes here, and just because of all the mileage there. So let me know if you guys have any good experience with the Pegasus road shoes. Let me know in the comments. I'd like to know. And this ends this video, and hope everyone keeps safe out there. Keep running. And we'll see you next time.